Fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. Here's the kick. Number 26 fields it at the three. They'll go to work at the 24-yard line. He's backfield. They'll throw on first down. Throws this one out to the right. This incompletion is credited to the lineup.
Absolutely. The quarterback executed his end of the deal.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. And they have three receivers bunched. On the ground, up the middle. Kirk, they really had nothing going on that run.
I'll tell you what, Brad. It's almost like he ran into a brick wall on that play.
Oregon has one of the top defenses in the nation. Have a look at the stats.
Well, I'll tell you what, this whole defense seems to be full of All-Americans.
No doubt about it. These kids are the real deal.
He's going right. Good. With a big down. Oh, my. That long game gives him a first down of coach.
A first down on a nice pass play. Knowing you can convert a third wall to open up your offense a little bit more on first and second. Let's see what they do from here.
It's first and 10, ball in the 40. Drops back to pass. He's under pressure. Wants to throw outside. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. Poor decision to throw it into such tight coverage. So it's second and 10, and this is the fifth play of the current drive. Ohio State comes out with an I formation, makes a move, tackle, and the halfback carries for a pickup of three. The defense will try to stop this third down as they were unsuccessful the first time on this drive. One man backfield. He drops back, steps up, throws this one out to the right. Drop down. Nice play call to get up a conversion.
And a deep conversion on third down makes a really frustrated defense. When they convert a third and long, it just makes them sick.
First and 10. This is the seventh play of this drive. Number 30 lines up in a deep back in formation, and he's taken down. The fullback picks up about 3 yards on that carry. Second and 7 coming up here, and this is the eighth play of the drive. He gets another carry, and now he's got one to run, and down he goes, and he busts That's a big one on this defense.
Boy, this halfback is running the ball. I'd put a few more guys in the box there defensively to try to stop him.
First and 10. This is the ninth play of this drive. Ohio State goes with the ace set here.
This defense.
You're right. Poor halfback. He had nowhere to go.
It's second down and 11 to go. And this is the 10th play in the drive. Ohio State in a five-wide set. Throws it to the outside. And this one's going to get intercepted. Out of bounds. Nice pick by the safety.
Safety that time just sitting back there looking at the quarterback, and once it was thrown, he knew exactly where it was going, and he made the pick.
I'd sell the pass here, and then I'd hand it off to my halfback.
They'll set up shop at the 5-yard line. Dixon with three wide receivers on the ground with the tailback. And he's tackled. Well, they get 5 yards there on the halfback draw.
As a coach, you got to be concerned with what the defense is throwing at you. I tell my quarterback to take what the defense is giving you.
They're bringing their dive package. Back to pass. Looking. He's going left. Great coverage, and it's intercepted. Ball is loose. A nice recovery there by the quarterback.
Well, usually you see these defensive backs picking up passes. Not one did they get a chance to pounce on Buckeyes.
See if they can get it in for the touchdown. They'll try to power it for the fullback. They'll bring him down. Nothing gained on the play. Expect the defense to turn it up a notch here in the red zone. Pitches back. It's on the ground. Brought down. So the defense comes away with a big, big turtle.
Oh, the quarterback is really going to hear from the coach now. He should not have fumbled that football. I'm telling you, this is a dangerous situation to be in. He's going to keep it on the ground and throw my guys the whole lot of football.
They don't want to make any mistakes in this situation. Dixon with the give, and they make the stop. And with that run, they can breathe a little easier.
Throw a little play-action pass here. Get the cut, get the fight, and it could be a big play.
First and 10. Ball on their own 16. Whitehead lines up as a single back. Dixon makes a handoff. He rolls out to the left. He's going left. And he's taken down. They gain 5 yards there.
As a coach, you love mismatch. In this case, if the slot guy's covered by the linebacker, you may have a nice play.
Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on 21. Ohio State lines up in a dime defense here. He rolls out to the right. Looks. Throws this one out to the right. Incomplete pass. And a great job that time on defense.
Good job here, but let me tell you something. That wide out was left out to dry that time.
Look, the option is a good call here. You just got to remember one thing. No turnover.
It's third down. 5 to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. The Buckeyes. Line up with a nickel back. They go with a run. They'll bring it down. How about that conversion on third down?
You got to give credit to the offensive line. Good push by the guys up front. They're really working hard down in the trenches.
Let me tell you, the biggest compliment you could give a coach is that his team is playing hard. And you're right. These guys are playing real hard. I mean real hard right now.
The Ducks line up in nine formation. He's looking. He's rolling right. Over the middle. His back makes the catch. And a good completion that time.
This pitch play is a good call here. I get my guy psyched up the block out there.
Second and one. This is the sixth play of this drive. The Ducks line up with three wide. Whitehead gets it on a pitch. And they make the stop. And they gain enough on the short toss for the first down.
A team that can run the ball has the best chance of winning. So I try to establish the run here.
It's first and 10. And this is the seventh play of the front drive. He's backfield. He drops back. Looking, rolling out to the right side. Wants to throw outside. And he's tackled. How about your assessment of that long play, Kirk?
Well, Brad, not only a big pass play, but anytime you can stretch a defense on first or second down like this, you're going to open up your running game.
And that's the end of the quarter. We're scoreless after one.
This is what power football is all about. You got to be able to run between the tackles.
First and 10. This is the eighth play of this drive. Whitehead, the lone back, on the ground with the tailback. Drop down. And he picks up great yardage on the run.
Yeah, and it looked like everybody else was in slow motion on that one. Boy, his skin is fast. Not to run over the perfect. You just got to make sure you turn the ball over when you're on scoring position.
For the first time today, we'll get to see how this defense responds when they're backed up into the red zone. They'll go with a run once again. They'll drop him for a loss. And he couldn't go anywhere on that one.
Now, he couldn't go anywhere because there was no place for him to run. The defense in front got a good push and knocked that offensive line backwards.
Hayes backfield. Dixon drops back to pass. Rolls right. End zone! Someone got a hand up.
As a quarterback, you have some options as to where you can go with the ball to get the first down.
Dixon comes to the line with three wide. He's going left. It's Dixon. Fantastic play by the quarterback.
Well, you know, that's a back to the quarterback.
And
that's how you play.
Here we go. They'll try to make this a field goal game. It's up, and it sails through the upright. Time to take a look at the drive summary. It's brought to you by Buckeyes, fuel for the soul. Number 25 is lined up to kick this one off. We should have a return on this one. Number 26 fields another one. So the offense comes down after their last drive and the ball end up in the defense's hands by way of a fumble. They'll take over at the 21. They'll throw on first down. Down the middle. The ball's incomplete. It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 21. Ohio State comes out with five receivers. And they make the stop. The quarterback gets a couple on the draw play. Third and 8. Ball of the 23. The Buckeyes come out in the ace formation. Drives back and pass. He lets it go, and that one's falling incomplete. That one was thrown in the direction of the tight end.
And as a coach, you hate to see the perfect play call wasted because of poor execution. Here, the quarterback just overshot this time.
It's fourth down, and the punt team lines up. He gets it away. William takes it to 47. The defense was able to keep them out of the end zone on their last possession, but the offense did pick up three. Excellent field position to start the drive. The Ducks line up in an I formation. Dixon on first down. Hooks. Throws this one out to the left.
And he went way up, and he got the interception.
That last INT gives his defense two on the day.
Not a good throw there, and the quarterback needs to make better decisions.
They'll get the ball here at the 38. Going with the shotgun here.
Wow, the kid just wanted to get smacked on that one.
Third and 15 coming up. Ball on the 33-yard line. The Buckeyes line up with three receivers bunched. Drops back to pass. Under pressure. They'll make the sack. A big time play by the defense.
Well, he just really overpowered the offense there. He simply used power to slide right through and come up with the pressure to bring down the quarterback.
Dixon with three wide receivers. Dixon drops the throw. Looks. He's going left. His receiver has it. More yardage there. That'll move the sticks.
Nice time to draw a pass here. It looked like the defense might have been looking run.
This is what power football is all about. You got to be able to run between the tackles.
Oregon comes to the line. Only one man in the backfield. Whitehead is coming inside. And he's taken down. That run by this halfback.
You know what? When this offense can run the ball like this, watch out. They can score quickly.
Watch out is right, because now you got to worry about the run and the pass on defense.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 33. Dixon on the option right. He's on the run. And he's shook out of bounds. Nice running on the option there.
That was a spectacular option keeper there. And I'm going to tell you why. It looked like that play was going nowhere, but this quarterback made the right choice by holding on to the football.
You're right. Good heads-up play there by the QB.
They're in the red zone again, but this time they should be thinking touchdown. Breaks one. And they make the stop. 3-yard gain by the running back.
You can smell the end zone. You know you're right there. Now smelling it and tasting it are two different things. You've got to be able to taste the end zone because it means 6 points.
Whitehead alone in the backfield. Dixon running the option. Tacks on the extra point. A little laundry on the field, and we'll find out whose it is.
Holy on us. And he got caught holding.
Yeah, you can't get caught with your hands on the outside of another player if you're going to block it. They have to stay in front, and that time the player didn't do that.
And he hits the PAT. This drive summary is brought to you by Buckeyes. Oregon to kick this one off. Number 26 and number 4, back deep to return. Kicks it off. And we've got a penalty on this one as it goes out of bounds. Let's get the call.
Taking a little bit off his passes in those situations.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball at the 35. He drops back. Here they come. Down the middle. Got it. And he's taken down. 9-yard pickup. The Buckeyes line up in a goal line formation. Lateral back. He spins it. Bounces off the lead tackle. Tucker tackles him for a loss on the play. Nice defensive stand there.
And some good play calling defensively. They always had something in the right spot to make a play and force the three out.
So they're set to bunt this one away. He gets it away. Williams takes it to the 43. The run game was a big factor in this offense's last drive when they got down the field for a touchdown.
Time to have a little fun out here. Let's see if both defenses are ready for this one.
They line up high. Dixon to the air on first down. Down the middle. Got it to his receiver. He's hit and got away. Yeah, we got an injured player on the field.
Tell your kids that this is where they earn their stripes.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 37. Going with the shotgun here. Dixon on first down. Down the middle. Quick coverage and it's intercepted. There.
Well, they're still down by a couple of scores, but the turnover certainly helps their chances. If they score this drive, they're right back in the game.
They'll take over at the 32-yard line. The Ducks bring in the nickel package. They'll throw on first down. Steps up. Goes to the right.
Got hit as he threw.
He let that one go before the defense got to him, and it fell incomplete.
Sometimes if you can safely get rid of the ball, it's your best option.
Second and 10, ball on the 32-yard line. Ohio State lines up with a shotgun set. Drops back to pass. He steps up, looking. He rolls out to the right. He wants it all, going long. Almost picked off. What a huge break for the offense. He has his ball and one. This is a good one. It's third down to 10. Ball of the 32. The Ducks line up in a nickelback. Back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Looks. Once and all. And he drops it. Oh, he drops it in the end zone.
That might be one of the worst things that could happen to a player. You got to touch that end. He dropped it.
The field goal unit lines up. This will make it a one-score game. The kick is up. And it sails through the upright. This drive summary is brought to you from our good friends at Buckeyes. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Kicks it off. Colvin fields it in the end zone. Complete in our national championship. The score at the break is Oregon 10, Ohio State 3. We'll see what kind of halftime adjustments were made as we prepare to start the second half. Kicks it off. Williams fields it in the end zone. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty. So they'll blow back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here. They're going to work at the nine. Oregon comes out of the shotgun. Dixon on first down. Fires across the middle. Hits it. And it's incomplete. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
As a coach, you love mismatch. In this case, if the slot guy's covered by the linebacker, you may have a nice play.
The Ducks go with the I formation. Dixon drops back. He's rolling right. Over the middle. Inbound makes the catch. And the 30. Tackle. And they get the first down on that completion, Coach.
That was a very nice first down conversion. The key to that play was the fact that the quarterback had plenty of time to look downfield.
As a coach, you love mismatches. In this case, if the slot guy's covered by the linebacker, you may have a nice play.
The Buckeyes line up with six defensive backs. Rolling out to the left side. He's looking. He's got a flat. And he dropped it. He couldn't hang on to that one, guys.
Well, I can't blame him for dropping that one. Did you see how hard that ball was thrown?
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. The Buckeyes bring in the nickel package. Fullback on the inside give. A 4-yard pickup by the fullback.
The option is a good call here. You just got to remember one thing. No turnovers.
Third and six. Ball on their own 37. Here's the option. They'll whistle him down to the backfield. So they wrapped him up before he could get anything going.
Now this offense is trying to establish the option game, but right now there's nothing there.
You think that wasn't a turnover? That one was good pitching.
The drive stalls, and they'll have to punt it away. Martinez gets it off. Number four, fields it at the 27. Middle. Once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. They'll start this drive at the 40. Oregon lines up with five defensive backs. He drops back. Looking. Here comes the pressure. And down he goes. This kid's been in the backfield all day long.
His ability to disrupt this offense and cause problems in the passing game has been absolutely tremendous. What a day for this kid.
It's second down and 12 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Oregon brings in the nickel here. Hand off on the counter. Woods with a takedown. The running back picks up a yard on the counter. 11. Ball on the 39-yard line. The Ducks line up with a nickel back. Drop back to pass. He's going right. He made the catch, and they're still going to be short.
Hey, if you would have gotten some yards on first and second down, you wouldn't have needed so many on third down.
The special teams coach sends his punt team out on the field. He punts it away. It's a high kick. Williams, he'll get it to Foster. And that will see the offense come out of the field for their next possession.
As a coach, he loves this pass. In this case, if the slot guy's covered by the linebacker, you may have a nice play.
They come out with three wide receivers. Whitehead gets the carry right side to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 26. The Ducks line up with three wide. Setting up the play action. Look. He's going to go for the home run. And he's all the way down to the 37-yard line. What an outstanding play that was.
Yo, that was a perfectly designed pass play. And they ran it to perfection.
The key here is making sure the offensive line gives the quarterback plenty of time to find the open receiver.
Oregon goes for the ace set here. Handoff up the middle. And he's taken down. Pickup of about three.
They got him. Pounded it inside until the defense calls for mercy here.
It's second down and seven to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. Stop. Gain of a yard by the fullback.
This is not an easy conversion, folks. I run the ball here and maybe get some defense.
Oregon comes to the line with three wide. Dixon gives it to Smith. There's a missed tackle. Hoping to extend the lead and make it a two-score game. It's up. And it is good. And that was not an easy kick, guys.
Forget about it. This kid can make it from 60 yards or further.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Four fields it in the end zone. The defense did a nice job of shutting down this offense the last time they had the ball.
The offense is not clicking at all. Let's see if they're back on the same page.
They'll get the ball here at the 15. One man backfield. Flags are all over the place and they'll blow it dead.
Let's start on the offense.
They'll be called for an infraction. That will put them back a few paces.
Man, the coaches are going to have to talk to these young guys about committing unnecessary fouls.
First and 15 now. Ball on the 10-yard line. There's the play fake. Throws it to the outside. The big guy let it go through his fingers.
The tight end's hands are all torn up and his knuckles are swollen. They're blocking every day in practice. You gotta give this guy a break.
I don't know about that, coach. Nowadays, tight ends gotta be able to do more than just block. Should have caught that ball.
They come out in a five-wide set. Steps up. He's working. He's going left. And he puts him down. They'll bring him down. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Third down and three coming up. Ball on the 22-yard line. come out in a goal line set. We are one quarter away from crowning the national champs. Our score through three, Oregon 13, Ohio State 3. It's third down and three to go. Ball at 22. Ohio State will line up in a jumbo set here. Third and short, they hand it off. Ball brings it down. And that will be enough for the first down.
Great job here by the defense in shutting down the run. It's a real plus for this team.
It's fourth down. Gets it off. Nelson reveals it for Boyd. He's in. Got away. Good job on their last drive, getting three. See if they can get some more on this drive.
There's a quarterback. You've got to be aware of what the defense is going at you.
Single setback for you. Whitehead takes a hand off. Gets past the tackle. And down he goes. And he gets a yard on the run.
I like trick plays, and this is sort of a trick play. You get the defense to commit to the run for a second, and hopefully they'll free up some receivers downfield.
Oregon goes with the ace set here. Missed that one, and he's tackled. The halfback rips off a nice gain there to get him the first.
Yeah, this guy's a good-looking back. Let's see if they go to him again.
Instead of running right at him, you could run around him on this pitch play.
Whitehead lines up as a single back. Whitehead hits a pitch, broke away from one, brought down, gain of about a yard on the halfback toss.
I keep it on the ground with an option here. It's let my quarterback make the decision to keep it or pitch it.
Oregon comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Here's the option left. He laterals. Down he goes, and he just eclipsed the 1,000-yard mark for rushing.
You know, to a lot of people, it's no big deal if a guy runs for over 1,000 yards in a season. But I'll tell you what, it takes some skills to be able to accomplish this feat.
They'll try to power it to the fullback. And he's taken down. He's not just a big lumbering guy out there.
Yeah, he is. He's a big lumbering guy with some speed. Good-looking run for the first attempt.
It's first and 10, and this is the sixth play of the drive. Oregon will line up in a jumbo set here. They hand it off. He breaks free. Tackle. They can just feel it, can't they?
Oh, boy, when you have a lead in a national championship and your line is making holes like that, watch out, sweethearts. Good teams are the teams that can score touchdowns in the red zone. Let's see if this team is a good team.
They're in the red zone where last season they came away with a third down field goal. About 5 yards there on the fullback carry.
Not to run here would be perfect. You just got to make sure not to turn the ball over when you're in scoring position.
The Ducks come out of the ace formation. Dixon on the option. He laterals the ball. Brought down. 3 yards there on the play.
In this short yardage situation, you got to make sure not to pick the ball unless you absolutely have to.
Oregon lines up in a goal line set. Dixon options out, and he's taken down. That's a pretty nice run there.
Yeah, for a first down, too.
And anytime you can get production like this from the fullback, give the defense something else to worry about.
I like to split the defense and throw the ball in a goal line situation just like this.
See if they can take this one in for six. Touchdown, Oregon! And he tacks on the extra point. Time to take a look at the drive summary. It's brought to you by Pontiac. Fuel for the soul. Oregon lines up for the kickoff. He kicks it. Number 26 fields it at the one. Pickup through the air.
I'll tell you what, fellas, I love this kid's throwing ability. He's got a quick release and he's very accurate.
The Ducks bring in the nickel package. Down the middle. Tackle. Good yardage on that completion.
The interesting thing about this play is the fact that they ran the same play two times in a row. And I'll tell you what that means. That means that the coach is seeing some sort of a mismatch out there.
And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
First down and five to go. Ball on the 41. The Ducks line up in a nickelback. Throw short, and it's caught. He's knocked out of bounds. He fired that ball in there.
Yeah, good execution there. Nice job of getting the first down on that pass.
Ball on their own 48. The Ducks bring in the nickel package. They'll throw again. Defense hasn't stopped them yet. Wants to throw outside. Oh, picked off. They just couldn't capitalize on the bad pass. State calls a timeout, and they'll have two remaining. It's third down and two to go. This is the sixth play of this drive. Oregon brings in the nickel here. Third and short, and they'll throw for it. Watch the ball. Good awareness defensively that time by the linebacker. So after another exciting year of college football, we can finally name our national champion. Your thoughts on the game, guys?
What a year of college football, and what a year it's been for our national champs. They showed more heart and determination than any team I've seen in a long time. There were doubters during the season, but they continued to prove everybody wrong. Now they're down on the field as the number one team in college football. My congratulations to everybody on the team. They showed the nation what it takes to be number one.